Good morning to all of you. I welcome you all this for the program on aggregate technical and commercial losses and reduction. It is a part of the energy efficiency in DISCOMs series, and this is the series one. I may be producing around 10 series to cover the entire energy efficiency DISCOMs, including the auditing of the systems of that. Now, the power generated in the power plants and transmitted by the transmission companies is called a transcos, and then distributed to the final consumers by the distribution companies called the DISCOMs. While power and energy is transmitted, there will be losses called the transmission and distribution losses. These losses are called the T&D losses, and they are technical losses and commercial losses. The technical vocabulary and the units what we use generally in making various calculations. The one is the active power, root 3 into voltage into current into power factor, that is a watts. And power is measured in kilowatt or megawatt or gigawatt. So the watts you can convert it by dividing by 1000. Energy power, the energy is the power multiplied by the time, it comes in watt hours. But whereas the energy recorded is in kilowatt hours, and we call it as generally units, and the units is mentioned in your electricity bills. Next is the reactive power measured in watt, voltage, amperes, reactive, and also in kVAr. Whereas the power factor is somewhere between 0.3 to unity, mostly lagging, but when you connect the power factor improvement capacitors, it goes into the leading, but our aim is always to retain it somewhere around 0.95, either plus or minus. And the apparent power is measured in kVA, that is a volt amperes, and the transformers are always mentioned in the apparent power. Now, important formulas what we come across in this is the power is kilowatts. Root 3 into V into A into power factor. The power factor is, we call it as a cos phi also, divided by 1000. And the reactive power kVAr is equal to root 3 into voltage into amperes into sin phi divided by 1000. And apparent power is equal to root 3 V into A divided by 1000. Whereas the power factor, what we call generally cos phi, is active power divided by the apparent power. And those two equations are given on the top. So it is a kVA cos phi by kVA, that is equal to cos phi. Whereas the energy is a power into time, kilowatt hours, units. And reactive power measured in VAR or kVAR. Generally people call this a VAR. Spelling is VAR, you write in capitals. And power factor for the systems are generally 0.3 to unity, either lagging or leading. It is a now transmission and distribution losses, also called as a T&D losses for short. Energy losses occur in the process of supplying electricity to the consumers due to technical and commercial reasons. The technical losses are due to the energy dissipated in the conductors, transformers, and other equipment used for the transmission and transformation and sub-transmission and distribution of power. You can also notice that the I square losses are in the conductor, and no load and full load losses are in the transformer, and low power factor. If there is a low power factor, it draws more current. So your I square R will increase. So our aim is always to maintain a power factor of at least 0.95, so that we don't end up paying the penalty to the DISCOMs. And other losses will be due to HT-LT ratio. How much is the length of the conductor you have taken? If length of the conductor LT is more, drop is more because current is more. That is why nowadays many of the DISCOMs are switching over to high voltage transmission, high voltage DS distribution systems. Why it is? So that you reduce the losses of that. Now you can see many of the multi-storied buildings, the transformer is kept more close to their compound wall, and HT is supplied at 11 kV, There is no LT line at all. Directly, the service is given to your building itself, where you have some MCCCs available for the distribution. Right. Now we will see that energy losses occurred in the question. Now, T&D losses, pilferage by hooking, you know it already, bypassing the meters and defective meters. Meters have different types of defects, which we will see it. And errors in meter reading, it may be reading overwrite, over or under readings. And the estimate the under metered supply. Estimating the under metered supply, that we'll be making a mistake also in that energy or the main sources of commercial losses. When commercial losses are added to the technical losses, it gives a transmission and distribution losses. There is another component of commercial losses which attributed to the non-recovery of the billed amount. You have billed it, let us say for a lakh of rupees, but he is paying only less than that. Sometimes he doesn't pay. Sometimes the billing itself is wrong. These are all comes into billing point of view. There is a dispute, so the customer is not going to pay, which is reflected in the collection efficiency. So T&D losses together with the losses in collection gives us aggregate technical and commercial losses, or simply it is called AT&C losses. Now the methodology for computation of the T&D losses and ATC losses is, now the first one is T&D losses is equal to begin a bracket 1 minus total energy billed divided by total energy input in the system, multiplied by 100. Second one is aggregate losses is 1 minus billing efficiency multiplied by collection efficiency, bracket close into 100. Now, what is this? Billing energy, billing efficiency is the billed energy by energy input. Now, whatever the energy input you have given, if you have billed for the same amount of energy, it is a unity. But because of the technical losses, the figure will not come as a unity. It may be something like a 0.8989% billing efficiency of that. And the collection efficiency is revenue collected by billed amount. You have billed amount for a more, and revenue collected is less. So then it will also be less than unity, maybe something like a 0.8. If you are able to bill it correctly, and if you are able to completely recover all the revenue from all the residents or whatever, maybe agriculturalists and industries, the collection efficiency almost goes to unity. Otherwise, the multiplication of these two, you have to put on the top of that, and you will get the ATC losses of that. Thank you very much to all of you for listening this. And we have a questions and answers session if it is a practice, this one, contact program. Otherwise, you can write the questions at the end of the YouTube program so that I will go through and answer you. And the next one will be energy efficiency in DISCOMs, so series 02, that I'll be talking on the energy efficiency distribution transformers on the technical side of that. And thank you very much to you all.